Hey guys, what's up? It's Abby. Today I'm going to be doing a reaction video on the Jonas Brothers S.O.S. Now, for those of you who are new to my page, first of all, welcome. Secondly, I am a huge Joe Bro fan, and I have been smiling ear to ear since they have gotten back together. Now, to put this in context for you, the Jonas Brothers started making music when I was 10 years old. Nick Jonas is 3 years older than me, so yeah. I, however, did not start getting into them until about sixth grade. So when I was 11, 12, and I still remember It's About Time. I remember when S.O.S. first came on, you know, I remember when they did the theme song for Disney's American Dragon, Jake Long. Like, I've been with them through all of it. I've also been on their first tour with Hannah, the Best of Both. I've been to the Best of Both Worlds tour. I've been to their Burning Up tour and their Lines, Vines, and Trying. I've been to all of their tours. And as I mentioned in my Only Human reaction video, I will be in Philadelphia and concocting a Happiness Begins montage for you. And to put this in even more context for you, the last time I saw the Jonas Brothers, I was 15 years old, and I'm 24 now. So imagine, like, your favorite band just being like, no, like, bye, we're not doing anything anymore. And then, you know, there aren't even words. And, you know, my colleague that I sit across from, he's like, you're such a creep. There's going to be, like, 12-year-olds. And I was like, I don't think he understands, like, the demographic of fans. So I'm so excited. I had the Jonas wall, you know, with all their posters. I bought, like, Tiger Beat and Teen Bop and Star, and, like, they had, like, a Teen Star, all J14, just to get their posters. Like, all I wanted was the posters. I didn't really care about celebrity news. I just cared about reading the Jonas Brothers interviews. So, without further ado, we will be reacting to the Jonas Brothers, literally, first original single. Year 3000 is a cover. I want to clarify that because I feel like a lot of people don't realize that that's not their song. It is their song in the sense that they're covering it, but their first hit single was S.O.S. So, here we go. Oh my gosh, their outfits. Oh my gosh, the girl's outfit. It's such a mid-2000s thing, the layering and the stripes. The shaggy hair was a big deal back then too. Now it's more like we're styling with pomade, I feel like. Look how offended the girls are. They're like, Converse. The scars were, do you remember the scars being in, like, for men and women, the huge scars? Wow, I'm so stupid. At 24, I understand why they're on a ship for this music video. S.O.S. I actually concocted a dance for this song. Yes, get that fedora, babe. Oh my gosh. Arias, what? Moises Arias. It's on Ham, Montana. This takes me back, like the clothes, the sound, the aesthetic. They all had like caterpillar eyebrows, especially That's like in now though, you know? Nick's hair was huge. Like, I was shocked when he shaved his head. Because, you know, his bushy hair was, like, one of the things he was known for. So, post-video thoughts. First of all, can we talk about the girls' outfits? Does anyone else remember layering the shirt on top of the shirt? Like, the Camp Rock style, the Disney style, the iCarly style. And then does anyone remember the little Bermuda shorts that were like such a big deal? And the plaid Bermuda shorts, because I definitely do. And their cell phones were just also old, which makes me feel so old. That was only 6 years ago. Also, let's talk about the fact that, you know, the wavy hair, like boy, they're definitely trying to fit the boy band mold. With Kevin had the wavy hair, Joe had the wavy hair. I don't remember fedoras being a thing, but apparently that was their style. The scarves, the layered scarves, oh girl. I don't even know who came up with that trend. I know some people wear scarves, but living in the Midwest, I've only worn scarves for winter, like, you know, and then fall when the seasons actually change. And when I went to LA, everyone was wearing scarves in the summer. I was like, is this needed? Like, I feel like it's not. So, but yeah, I love S.O.S. It really brings me back. Listening to some of their lyrics, you really have to think about how, like, I don't want to say emo because they don't have an emo sound, but how dramatic the Jonas Brothers were writing those songs as teenagers. Like, it's like I'm walking on broken glass. Can't believe I've bled. And I'm not making fun of them because I definitely like fell into that as a teenager. Like, I was a teenager listening to teenagers make music. Like I said, Joe Jonas just turned 30. I'm 24. Nick is 3-4 years older than me. So, like, you know, I think that's why women my age, girls my age related so much, because it was like they were boys who were close in our age, and it's like kind of going through the same things. So, but some of their lyrics are just so cheesy. Like, it's a call I'll never, I don't know. It's a call I'll never get. And Joe Jonas being like, what was that? Like, I still just don't understand. And looking at them now, like, it's weird looking at them be all mature and like not teenagers, you know? Cause like in my mindset, like, I fell in love with them when I was teenagers, when they were teenagers, you know? So yeah, S.O.S, classic, you know, everyone, I hate when like, people are like, oh, the year 3000, like, I like that song, but like, I feel like everyone forgets about S.O.S. Like, people who don't know the Jonas Brothers who are like, oh yeah, like, I've heard the year 3000, I'm like, but have you heard S.O.S. or like, Hold On, which is the next video I'll be reviewing. And if you liked anything I said, if you didn't like anything I said, because we welcome all opinions on this channel, be sure to leave a comment below. Be sure to like, subscribe, share with your friends, tell your mama, tell your papa, tell your dog. And next week, we will be back with another reaction video. As always, I will see you guys later, and trap out.